Welcome back, everyone. This is Joe. We are here with video number 40, so finally made it all the way up to 40 videos. This is the last one that I have planned, and it should be a pretty quick one. I will keep my eyes out going forward on the comments for new ideas, for stuff I hear at work, to see if I want to do like a series two or continue this in any way. Might branch off into a different channel. Undecided for right now, but I just want to bring you this one last one for now. Get us to 40 videos. And it's a pretty simple concept. I am not going to write any more measures. All we're going to do is clean up this page a little bit, duplicate it, and then I'm going to show you how to pull entity out into its own filter and then just put all of the measures on separate rows, because there probably will come a time where you want to just have filters and then display data. So averages, sums, like a bunch of different data line by line. If you're doing like a P&L statement, profit loss statement, and finance, this comes to mind because you're doing a lot of calculations that would come right from a table, like simple sums and averages, and then you're also doing ratio type stuff. So let's go ahead and do this. We're here in our DSBB Power BI 2 worksheet. Again, this is the last video, so only have 40. Recommend going all the way back to the start, but at least go back to the very start of the Power BI playlist to follow along with us and get to this point. If you're just looking for values on rows and the concepts that we're going to go over in this video, just try and follow along. So go up here, clear your dates by clicking this eraser. So now we're showing everything. Let's duplicate the page. Right click, duplicate. I will double click and call this value on rows practice. Let's first pull out the entity. So if you click this visual here, erase entity or uncheck it from over here, then we can grab our entity, put it in the blank space. Let's change it to a slicer. So this visual, use the drop down, change it to a drop down. Now I'll just resize a little bit and make ear meet it in the middle. And one other thing we need to do, I'll just select France for now. So we can select any entity, and now this is filtering over here, it's filtering the line chart, etc. I also turned my interactions back on, so I'll go over that in a bit. Don't worry about if your line chart's only showing one dot. We'll talk about that in a second. But I also want to put a select all on this dropdown, so keep your selection on this visual. Click Format Visual, Slicer Settings, Selection, and then do Select All. And now we can actually click this option to see all entities. But I'm going to toggle that off, go to France for right now. The edit interactions piece you might remember from an earlier video. If you select year, you may have to resize this a bit just to start so that the icons popped up, so that they pop up. So resize it, click on year, go to format, edit interactions, right? And then you see these icons pop up. So if I just do 1806, oh, I guess I didn't do this yet. So you'll see this, right? If you select anything, any two dates or whatever, right? Your year is filtering this over here. What we want to do is turn that off so that the year is on the bottom and then this slicer does not affect this visual at all. So I'll click this, resize it. When I'm done there, I can X out of edit interactions. And while I'm still selected on this visual, I'm just going to change this to year because first of year is doesn't make a whole lot of sense. We're just showing year on the bottom here, and it's still detecting our anomalies. So if you didn't see that video, go back to check out the anomalies video. That's kind of a cool one where you're just utilizing Microsoft's help to do some quick and dirty machine learning to detect anomalies. Okay, so we have a couple years selected. We have France selected. I'm just going to go ahead and select 2011. So we have 1 year to compare this sheet to the last one. And then here on this visual, this is where I want to do all of the work. We're showing everything in columns, and if we change this to a matrix, we're doing the same thing, but we don't want to display data that way. We want to have line by line, one after the other. So if we want to do that, we can go to here, go to values, go to options, and then switch values to rows, and now everything is displayed on its own row. And rather than have this card here, now it makes sense where we can just delete this and then pull that measure, it's the one that's not used over here on the bottom, to the bottom. And then it will always make sense because we're going to tell it what entities where we want it to do the min and max subtraction. So now I can just resize this a little bit, pull this over to the left, make the line chart a little bigger as well, this looks pretty good. If you want to do some styling just to make this look like a nicer dashboard, I can click the chart here, come here, style presets, and I'll just do condensed. So now to just double check these, right? So 2011 France, we have 81.71 and 82.07. So if we go here, filter on 2011, we should see the exact same thing in the chart. We're using the same measures. So here's France, here's your 81.71 and your 82.07 for average for selected year and average selected year to present. So we're all good there. We're seeing a 16.15 because that's doing this 82.66 minus the 66.51. We should get that same 16.5 number if we just do all entities by clicking the eraser, and here it is, 16.15. The nice thing about having this on the chart now and letting the year and entity filters do all the work for us, we can just select whatever entities we want, and now it's really truly dynamic, right? Because the 7.79, we can't see that anywhere for these three entities that we just randomly picked. We would actually have to find which one is the largest on this chart and then subtract it from which one is the smallest. And if you do that, it will tie. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. I hope you've enjoyed all 40 videos up to this point. I know it was pretty Power BI heavy, but we sprinkled in a lot of other topics as well. I think this puts a bow on what we've done up to this point. It was beginner level to intermediate, I would say, with a few advanced topics sprinkled in. So that's all I have for right now. I will keep an eye on the comments, just stray comments that I hear at work, wherever, and might come back with something at some point. But until then, I encourage you to review, go back, and look at all of the other videos again, and try to follow along. Leave comments. I'll take any feedback I can get as long as it's useful. And thank you for following along. So take care.